Thank you very much. It is a pleasure to be here. I'm delighted to be part of this dedication. As you've heard, and as some of you know, the University of Michigan and the Medical Center in particular has been an important part of the life of the Wilensky family and the Rogan family, my maiden name, my husband Robert and myself, my brother and my brother-in-law, cousins, nephews, and so on. But beyond the varied ties of affection, there is a particularly propitious moment that we are using today to dedicate the Brehm Tower. The passage of healthcare reform has focused the attention of the country on healthcare. And while there's been a lot of debate about the specifics, and there'll be more legislation to come, as there always is for complex issues, the general goals are ones that we all embrace, making sure that all of us have access to high-quality, affordable care, continuing to provide leadership in the advancement of medical sciences and the development of new technologies, as well as a continued advancement of therapeutic strategies. But it also means learning how to best use these innovations in ways that will both improve the health care of individuals without impairing the fiscal health of our country. These are not small challenges or modest goals, but it has frequently been that when we have been challenged the most, that we respond the best. It is incumbent on all of us to make sure that that happens now. Within that context, I want to share a couple of observations relating to how the Brehm Tower we are dedicating now will impact this future. First, research, particularly collaborative research, will provide the foundation for our future successes in improving the lives and well-being of our aging population. It was not by accident that Bill and Dee Brehm chose Michigan to help lead the way in improving the prevention and treatment of type 1 diabetes. The willingness of the university to help support their ideas of collaborative research and the foundation of the Brehm Coalition of Scholars were key to that decision. The collaborative nature of this building, embracing, as we know, eye disease and diabetes, being able to add two floors of labs to the design of the Kellogg addition, the collaboration and friendship between Paul Lichter and Bill Brehm, these have all been crucial to bringing this important first stage to fruition. It is my hope that the type of collaborative research that we see represented here will dominate research in the future. Our whole medical system has been characterized far too long by its silos. Silos of care, Medicare that I've been involved with, is infamous for its silos, but also silos in terms of how we teach the next generation of physicians, how we fund and conduct research, and how we make use of innovations and the technology that research produces. The second observation I want to share with you is the uniquely American partnership that exists between private philanthropy and education, the arts, sciences, and humanities. Whenever we have experienced natural or man-made disasters in the world, we can observe countries rushing to the aid of other countries and their peoples. Governments will offer to send supplies, relief efforts, first responders of all sorts. Our government does this as well. And as we have seen after the tsunami and the various earthquakes in China, Haiti, and elsewhere, this is important, and I in no way want to minimize the successes that the governments of the world have been able to show when called upon to help. But while most countries focus their efforts through these governmental responses, or occasionally through their religious institutions, it is only the U.S. that relies heavily on its corporations and its private citizens, a response that frankly confuses many of our friends from other countries, even the very wealthy among them. In fact, if you look only at government contributions in terms of what the United States does for the rest of the world or for our own people, You miss the generosity of what the American people are willing to provide. My own experiences at Project Hope give testimony to this very generous response. Early on the SS Hope, which many of those of you in Michigan participated in some way, or the staffing of the USN Mercy and Comfort more recently, helping to equip and staff the Basra Children's Hospital or the Shanghai Children's Hospital. But it is also what we are witnessing here today. Many of you in the audience have made substantial and significant contributions to this new addition, financial contributions, but other contributions is important as well. The Brehms, of course, have clearly made this a major focus of their philanthropic efforts. The Tower, the Brehm Coalition, the Brehm Scholars, and they have reached out to others to encourage them to contribute as well. Bill has been very important to me in helping me find a way to donate to the university that would allow me to repay some of what the university has helped me accomplish and also to leave a legacy that has particular personal importance to me. We cannot and should not underestimate the special role that goes on between private philanthropy and its ability to improve the quality of life in the United States, now and in our future. It is a unique American strategy of giving that is needed now and more than ever. Bill, Dee, thank you for all of you have done. And for all of you out in the audience who have contributed, thank you very much as well.